Okay, let's start quick. Good morning, everyone. I smell chicken.
That's the baddest news.
Okay.
That's what it is.
Yes. Ever see this right here? I was going to put the big sign on the, over there when Brother Greg put the same with God. It's a good message, I think. It just after this week, I don't know what I'm going to do, but I'm going to try. I got this because one day I took out, well, I went to Fred's or something. I just got out of the garage and, pull out the driveway. And my truck started speaking. My truck is pretty smart, and you know that? It can talk. I don't know he or she. It can talk. And it said, your phone is connected. Your phone is connected. You know what that means? Yeah, I left my phone at the house.
Oh.
Yeah, so it was thinking, but it just no more. So that can come in my mind. And I'm going to put this sign. Yeah, I will sometime. It's important. Think. I told Wednesday night, think. Okay, S-I-N-K. Yeah. Why the spell S-Y-N-C? As a synchronized, right? Synchronized women. I think that's what the Olympics they do. That's pretty. Same way. You just get the same wavelengths with God. And that's what it means. And this week I was just running all over the place. I was so frustrated because I'm getting out of the sink, out of the God's wavelengths or something. We'll talk about that. Let's start. Opening Bible is right here. Psalm 139, 1 through 16. Book of Psalms. Psalm 139. Number 1. O Lord, thou hast searched me and known me. Thou knowest my down sitting and my uprising, thou understandest my thought after all. Thou compass my path, I lying down, art acquainted with all my ways. For there is not a word in my tongue, but Lord, O Lord, thou knowest it altogether. Thou hast beset me behind and before. Lay thine hand upon me. Such knowledge is too wonderful for me. It is high. I cannot attain unto it. Whither shall I go from thy spirit? Or whither shall I flee from thy presence? If I ascend up into heaven, thou art there. If I make my bed in hell, behold, thou art there. If I take the wings of the morning and dwell in the uttermost part of the sea, even there shall thy hand lead me. Thy right hand shall hold me. If I say, surely the darkness shall cover me, even the night shall be light about me. Yea, the darkness hides not from thee, but the night shines as a day. The darkness and the light are both alike to thee. For thou hast possessed my frame, thou hast comforted me in my mother's womb. I will praise thee, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Marvelous are thy works, and that my soul knoweth right well. My substance was not hid from thee when I was made in secret and curiously wrought in the lowest part of the earth. Thine eyes did see my substance. Yet being imperfect, and in that book all my members were written, which in continuance were fashioned, when as yet there was none. Let us pray. Dear Lord, we come to you. I come to you with a heavy heart. And see the suffering of the people. But we all know you are still in control. We all know as you created this universe, you created me, all the people. So let us praise you in the storm. Let us see the sunshine like today. In our darkest time of the world. Lord, help us see your mighty work still exist. Through the cancer patient, through the tragedy, through the suffering. Because your darkness is light of the day. We hide nothing from you. Let us come closer to you. And let us be your servant as each step we take. We thank you, this church of Piney Grove Baptist Church. We have place and time to worship you. And this community, Lord, as the tragedy hits, we walk together, we unite, we sink unto you. So, Lord, help us. Help us to understand you. And help us be the faithful servant. Thank you for the many blessings we will receive. Be with us. The week ahead. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Okay, I put number one is the visibility. That's the word visible. Visibility. Visibility is the thing you can see. It's like this. Visibility is very important. I pastored the church at Mount View 7 years. Mount Joy Baptist Church. Between the Batesville and the Mountain View, there's a little church called Mount Joy Baptist Church. I pastored there 7 years. It was shut down for a long time. And when we have a church, obviously we have a call. And the Highway 14, that's the main road to the Batesville, all the way to Ozark Mountain. We are gateway to the Ozark Mountain. You know, Branson and all the places. Many people drive by and say, wow, that church. Then not open it. I talked about this morning, the late night I came drive by and see the porch light was on. You know what that means? somebody just drove around. I do that sometimes, just making sure that light works. Come on, like 9 o'clock, go around. When I drive by, sometimes don't work, so I had to back it up like twice. But the lights come on. You know, but what I'm saying is, somebody driving by right now and start counting the cars in the parking lot. I don't know you do. I do. When I, you know, skipping church service, I count the cars. I'm a mathematician. I have to count something. Yes. Especially when we have a 5 o'clock service on the, you know, Sunday, Wednesday night, and go to the other church, 6:30. Okay, they have 1, 2, 3, 4. Do that all the time. So beginning is the visibility. You see what is going on. Because we are curious nature. Most importantly, let's open up Ephesians 5:13. Ephesians 5:13. But all things that will be proved made manifest by the light, whatsoever do is made manifest is light. I want somebody to turn off the light and everything. I love to do that sometimes. I need to cover everything. Did I tell you about darkness last week? I talked about darkness. That's what's subject on me, but in the dark, you cannot see. But we just read that Psalm 139, that God can see you in darkness. Amen. So we're going to hide. No. Visibility of God is quite different than we, as we see. Now, what can we see is the important part. Okay. Because light, we can see each other. That's important. Now, what we're seeing is another thing. Let's open Acts chapter 10, 39, 40. We're going all over the place today. Acts chapter 10, number 39 said, we are witness to all things which he did both in the land of Jews and Jerusalem, whom the slew and hanged on the tree. Easter is coming up. They bound him and then pierced him. They hanged Jesus Christ. But that's not the end of the story. Let's go to number 40. Verse 40 said, him God raised up the third day and showed him openly. Amen. You know, raised him up so that we can see. Rolled the stone away. That Jesus need to roll the stone away to get out that tomb. I don't think so. He was go everywhere. But he rolled the stone away so that Sister Mary, the Magdalene, they can come in and look empty tomb. Empty tomb is to be proven what Jesus did. He's not in the grave. He is risen. That is Easter. That is our visibility. We understood Jesus is risen. Then go to unity. Let's go to Colossians chapter 3, Colossians, not Corinthians, Colossians, after the reading, Philippians, then Colossians, Philippians chapter 3, 10 through 14. Colossians chapter 3, verse 10. And have put on a new man, which is renewed in knowledge after the image of him that created him, where there is neither Greek nor Jew, circumcision nor uncircumcision, barbarian or Scythian, or bond or free. But Christ is all, and in all. Put on therefore, that as the elect of God, holy and beloved, bowel of mercy, kindness, humbleness of mind, meekness, long-suffering, forbearing one another, forgiving one another, if any man have a quarrel against any, even as Christ forgave you, so also do ye. Can we do that? Oh, sure can, because we are new creation. My old self, not. But the created by the God, the new creature, sure can forgive, sure can mercy and grace control my mind. Unity. I'm going to play the banjo. You know, banjo is one thing I picked up. I had this banjo for a long time and I didn't play it. Banjo is too cheerful. Too loud. But at the same time, yeah, I need some cheer up. I play the banjo. Because it's hard to cry to play in the banjo. You know that Beverly Hillbilly? Yeah. Just picking up so good. But listen.
Forgive the people unreasonable things happen.
Who give you the mercy? Who give you the kindness? Who can give you the humbleness of all over like God, Jesus died on the cross? Only Jesus can.
Amen.
So that's a unique. Let's open John 14:27. We all know chapter 14 of John, that is, let not your heart be troubled. Because in my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. That Bruegel song is called The Heart Never Break Again. I'll have a heart will have never break again. What? Anyway, the song online, I told you Wednesday night, but the song said there's a mansion built in the heaven, and a streak of gold will run by my front door. Isn't it good? Open the door, there's a gold streak all over the place. So John 14 and 20 said, conclusion of let not your heart be troubled. It said, peace I leave you, my peace I give unto you, not as the world gives. Give I unto you that let not your heart be troubled, neither let it be afraid. You know what the world can give it to you? Alcohol, painkiller, all kinds of medication. When I had an open heart surgery, you know, hydrocolon, yeah, they'll give it to me because pain is severe. But I told my wife, well, that medicine, it works like this. It just, pain is there, but I don't care. Right? It just, when I took a pill and just, okay, I can sleep a few hours. Miss Leah having a severe pain because I can't imagine. It just, and they said, stronger than morphine. I don't know what the medication is. Just push the button and give it to her. Any few hours. But that's not what Jesus is saying here. That's a peace I give it to you. Because we connected. Remember that my truck said, your phone disconnected, right? Dislocated. My God is not like that. My God said, I will never forsake you. I'll be with you. Wherever you go, I'll be with you. The psalmist in 139 said, dreadfully, I go to hell, but you are still in there. Oh yeah, God is everywhere. But the problem is, God is here, God is everywhere, but we are not connecting to the God. That's what the sin with God come from. So I'm going to play the banjo again. Oh my goodness. Thank you. could I go? And I need help. Randy, would you please open the heavenly highway 155, I think.
What do you want me to do?
Play the piano with me. We're not singing, but please listen.
If you go to worship God,
making sure that they using this word, they using the true thoughts. You have to have this Jesus who died on the cross because of you. That's the unity. Number four is functionary. Okay, number one, we talked about visibility, right? Yeah, car is there, so I'm happy, right? I was almost put if I drive the car like you know, any noise, would you drive two cars? Come on, it looked good in the parking lot. There you go, yeah. Parking lot overflow, just like that Diamond Park. Stop parking on the street. Let's do that. Visibility is the one thing, then the functionality is one, another thing. The function right. That means the church, as we gather, it's not just a gathering. We have to some work to do. We got to do something to praise. We got to something to help each other. So that is come with that Finding Nemo. You just two people watched. It's a good movie. Would you take it as light?
Thank you. fish was saying, keep swimming, keep swimming. Any trouble, just keep swimming. And this one, swim down, that's important. But the one fish cannot do, right? You have to be unit. And one mind, fish or church member, community member, whatever it is, with mindset up, swing down, and not pretty. Let's all stand.